All right, you Flower Power Party crowd, how we doing, everybody? We still doing good? Seeing as this is the last big pool show of the Flower Power Cruise, we thought we would not only put a world-class act up here for the last show, but we also thought we would bring up a world-class act who also happens to be the best-dressed man on board to do a proper introduction. Do me a favor, whether you just came from his show or saw it yesterday, you know this man very well. Do me a favor, put your hands together for the fabulous Peter Asher.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Jason. I am not. I just borrowed a hat for the occasion. It's great. So, I was a big fan of this band back in England, as everybody else was too. And it's funny because traditionally, sometimes the music press in England divides bands into sort of categories, you know. And there's bands who are like hip and cool, and then there's bands who have hit records. And they're not usually the same band. But in fact, and then there's another kind of band which becomes famous for all the incredible members it has in the course of its history. And what's unusual is that all three of those attributes combined in the Yardbirds. Not only did they start off hip by having a name, which I've always assumed was a tribute to Charlie Parker, unless it isn't. Is Yardbirds a Charlie Parker reference or not?
Yes.
It is, okay. What, multiple, okay. So I always assumed it was Charlie Parker and nothing could be hipper than that. On top of that, they had some of the greatest guitar players in the world pass through the band like it was a school. And on top of that, they had huge hit records and records zooming up the charts in the traditional way. So it's a privilege and a pleasure on my part to introduce the Yardbirds.
Thank you, Peter. Thank you all.
Sitting hard and lonely, deep in dark despair. Thinking one thought only, where is she, tell me where? And if she says to you, she don't love me, just give her my message, tell her all my plea. And I know, we'll
in. That's what I got to say. The thing I say was planned in. I could do without. I got to say, if I say the thing I'm right here now, I ain't gonna stand my deadline. I'll reach the conclusion to all my mass confusion. Don't call me, baby, I'll call you.
I've been treated like a dog. Let's keep the oceans clean, no more muddy water. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce you to a gentleman sat here behind the drums here. Our original member and Rock and Roll Hall of Fame legend, Mr. James McCarty on the drums. Still strong in that engine room, right? Gotta keep this boat of going. Jim's keeping that us on our way home, right? We got a little song now. Well, song is full of a lot of difficult questions that we still haven't found the answers for. And if you have, you certainly are a better man than I.
Song was recorded in Memphis in Sun Studios, and I was sharing that story with the Box Tops. We were down in Box Tops territory. So young Jeffrey's playing his Les Paul.
Go fish and no gym jobs out there.
Don't play these games no more. Those little games are for little boys. Those big games are for bigger boys. Parties in Chelsea, flats, big scenes, drinking cats. Games are gonna play so long. You are bad. Thank you.
release those crickets over there. Here they come.
Oh, thank you, friends. And I mean that, friends, you know. It's really been a gas for us. You know, it's not always nice to come back and see all your friendly faces and reacquaint ourselves and catch up with all our musician friends as well. And aren't these bands just mind-blowing? You know? Wow, it's been a real delight for us. Anyway, I guess a little bit of rock and roll history here. When, you know, when you're a young group, you're just finding your feet, shit, you just found a good name for your band, you know? You know, do they sound good? Do we sound good, you know? And what a great name, the Yardbirds, you know? The Rolling Stones, the Kinks, all these bands, the Beatles, wonderful names for bands. So just finding a good name was tricky, let alone finding a number one song, right? So you had songwriters out there who were checking out with A&R people and publishers and all that. There was a wonderful cat named Graham Gouldman who wrote three songs for this band, including this very quirky one about a woman who's really not very nice. Anyway, a song called Evil Hearted You.
All the things they send along. Thank you. Sorry?
Oh yeah, that was a good one, was it? Yeah. Was that good? Yeah. Yeah, because we play that all the time and it's always different. So sometimes it's awful, you know. I can't remember yesterday. Yeah, it was okay. That was a great song by Howling Wolf, whose real name is Chester Burnett. And he was one of our favourites right back in the 60s, one of the great blues players. But to introduce you to the guys this afternoon, on my right-hand side, Mike Scavone from New York. Mike was in a New Jersey band called the Doughboys, and also, who was that other band, Mike? Mike, who's the other band?
Ram Jam.
Whoa, Ram Jam, yes. Black Betty. And next to him, the very highly esteemed Sir Godfrey Townsend. Yes, thank you, Godfrey. He's done a great job on this tour. He's been putting us up and getting us breakfast and carting the gear around. He's done everything. What a great guy, Godfrey. And he'll be on the what's it called? The Terrible Together Tour. The Awful Together Tour.
Miserable Together Tour.
He'll be on that again this year. And next to him, he's a legend in his own lifetime, Kenny Aaronson. And he's played with all these great bands like Billy Idol and New York Dolls, if I remember them all. Joan Jett, yeah. DR Birds. Kenny Aaronson. And on my left-hand side, he's been with the band a long time now, and he sang on the Birdland album, which was 2003. John Iden.
That's a pass, friends. Hey, Mr. James McCarty on the drums. Yeah. Good guy. Wow.
I wanted to say it's really lovely to play on this cruise. We've done about four now. And we always enjoy it, and we appreciate that you vote for us. I know a lot of you vote for us on the papers. We're very, very thankful to you because we love coming back. So we'll carry on with a song that put us on the map back in '65. I'm sure you'll remember that. And then we play a medley of songs. The second one is a song that was voted psychedelic UK single of all time by the Record Collector. And then the last one, I'm sure you know, it went on to another band that Jimmy Page started. I don't remember them. But you'll know that.
Your door.
Thank you.
Peace for us all, alright?
Thanks, everybody.